Reactions to a teenager's death. 15-year-old kids shouldn't be dying in our country. I want everyone to stand up to it. Why do we fail to defend our children's lives? Why are we so helpless? In her emotional Facebook video address on Tuesday, Tamar Khaladze, teacher and director of Tbilisi school Erudity, reacted to a reported suicide attempt by 15-year-old Lucas Siradze. The incident happened after he was allegedly reported to the police by a private school for vandalizing their property. We've seen many stupid things written on the school's walls, but I always realized that it is a child, a minor, who wants to express their feelings on the walls, and we dealt with this within the school. We, the staff, never called the police, never let our students become victims of psychological pressure. Not everyone is meant to be a school director, Khaladze insisted. Lucas succumbed to injuries on Tuesday, causing even bigger public outcry over suspected police misconduct. Following the news of a minor's death, youth groups took to the streets in several Georgian cities. They wrote, "Screw life," a phrase left written on the school walls. The hashtag was also widely used by users on social media platforms. "I'm also 15 and I'm also Luca today. I'm afraid. I don't want to live in a country like this," one user wrote on Twitter on Thursday. After initial reactions, some, including public health professionals, were worried about how the negative slogan could incite emotionally vulnerable youth to do self-harm. Some public figures weighed in to deliver a message of hope on Facebook. "Whatever you might be facing is better than death. Live, endure, have us help, use all the ways except doing harm to yourselves. Don't say screw life. Everything can be solved except death," Alexander Lortipanidze, presenter of a children's TV show, wrote on Facebook. Exposing police blackmail on Facebook. On Wednesday, sports journalist Sashka Kalmakhelidze wrote a lengthy Facebook status update giving a detailed account of his detention by police 2 years ago. Kalmakhelidze wrote that in January 2017, police grabbed and took him to a police station in Tbilisi where they tried to intimidate and blackmail him into ratting someone out in exchange for freedom. Kalmakhelidze said the death of a 15-year-old boy pressured by police pushed him to speak publicly about his own experience for the first time. "It's been 2 days and I haven't been able to think of anyone and anything other than that boy. Probably because I think I know better than others what he felt like, what pressure he endured, and how they broke him. Everyone has their reasons to be silent against the system, but when a 15-year-old kid jumps from the 9th floor and kills himself, there's nothing beyond that," Kalmakhelidze wrote. His Facebook post with over 3,600 words was reshared more than 2,000 times within a day, followed with words of solidarity to him and comments filled with anger and frustration with the Georgian law enforcement and judicial system.